Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. So those videos I do every so often that are like, don't waste your money, and we basically go through the top kind of like new skincare and product launches. I get a lot of good feedback on those because they're not just about products I don't want to try, they're just about new launches, you know, with like a catchy sort of clickbaity title. So yeah, I get a lot of good feedback and a lot of people are like, I kind of want you to try that, or I wonder what that is actually like. And sometimes you convince me to try things I didn't want to try, but also TikTok does the same thing. It's quite convincing when it comes to advertising some skincare products. So today I want to try some new releases, new launches that I've wanted to try, not really wanted to try, and ones that you've been curious about. I consider part of my job spending money on stuff so you don't have to, or so you can get like a bit of a review before you go out and buy it yourself. So let's start off with a product that I honestly really didn't want to try. However, some of you were like, I heard it's good. I've seen some other content creators who I really, really like and respect try this and say how good it is. So this is the Fenty Skin Cookies and Clean Detox Face Mask. Now, the initial reason, let's talk about why I didn't want to try this. First of all, I feel like it's a little bit odd for Fenty Skin. I feel it's more like e.l.f. than Fenty Skin. Do you know what I mean? I feel like it's something a bit more kitschy and a little bit tacky in a way. I always say tacky, I don't necessarily think tacky is bad. My background. But it just felt a little bit weird for Fenty Skin and I guess childish. I say that with stuffed toys in my background. I don't know. It just felt very different for Fenty Skin and it wasn't something I was interested in trying. Also, the look of it kind of made me feel a little bit ill. It looked like bacteria and stuff. But let's talk about this. This says, tired of feeling stripped or dry from masks, whipped clay and charcoal deeply cleanses and snatches pores, leaving them creamy, soft and smooth. So you're meant to apply an even layer on clean, wet or dry skin, massage into skin to mix the encapsulated charcoal into the clay, leave on for 10 to 15 minutes, rinse, pat dry, then follow with toner. So this whole whipped clay thing is something I really enjoy and that you see in a few other clay masks recently. It's meant to keep it more hydrating rather than drying, which is why I usually avoid clay masks. Because whilst they are good at temporarily kind of like removing any oils or anything like that, they can really dry you out. Clay masks don't dig deep into your pores, they don't suction anything, they're not magnets, but they can kind of like soak up what is on the surface layer or whatever it touches. So this has kaolin clay to it says extract dirt, oil and impurities, but as we just said, more like soak up. Charcoal helps detoxify pores, doesn't really mean anything. Absorb oil and impurities, pretty much works the same as kaolin clay. Salicylic acid, oh, we got a bit of BHA in here. We have rhubarb and ginger extracts to condition and soothe. Let's give it a go, why not? I am actually gonna apply a toner because my skin is already super dry. It's so dry. I shouldn't be doing this. I've got like this job tomorrow. I shouldn't really be experimenting with new skincare. It doesn't smell like anything. I'm just gonna do this in my T-zone because I do have a very dry like U area. So I'm just gonna, oh, oh, these little black bits are like literally encapsulated charcoal. They kind of pop. So you massage that onto your skin. The charcoal doesn't feel like scratchy or grainy or anything like that. The thing is, I must say, things like this usually annoy me because the encapsulated whatever or the little capsules, whatever it may be, charcoal, collagen capsules, hyaluronic acid capsules, tend to stick around on the beard and the face a fair bit. So I tend to avoid those, really. Boop. Oh no, okay. I'm not really gonna show you a before and after as far as like how my pores look because I'm not struggling with my pores at the moment. I think they're fine, but what I will talk about is how dry my skin feels, if it feels overly dried out, which kaolin clay usually does make me feel. We'll see. So let's give it 10 minutes. Oh, actually, before I do that, let me grab a wet one. So clay mask I actually do like is the Glow Recipe Watermelon Hyaluronic Clay Pore Tight Facial. This again is kind of like whipped clay with infused with hyaluronic acid, so it doesn't dry you out. But also this Otzi Dough Therapy Pore Tight Mask really does remind me of this Fenty one. I swear this pot has gotten bigger. I don't remember it being this big. Yeah, like it's very similar. It's kind of like this bouncy
kind of texture.
And has this more kind of like puddingy slime kind of texture to it, rather than grainy, sandy, you know, like clay feeling to it. So this is a really, really nice option. But yeah, okay, let's give that a while. Give it 10 minutes and we'll come back and see how it feels. Okay, it's been 12 minutes for some reason. And I was going to go to 15, but I thought I'm just going to stop now. It's not drying, which isn't a bad thing. I actually think that's quite nice. Like, it's definitely not wet. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's not going to come off, but it's not drying down. You know, usually when you do a clay mask and you frown and do all that kind of stuff, it cracks. It's not doing that at all, which to me is a good sign that it's not overly drying. So I'm going to go rinse it off and then we'll take a closer look at my skin and just see kind of how it looks after. Okay, so it's rinsed off. It rinsed off super easy, literally just like fell off the skin, which is nice because there wasn't any like aggressive rubbing on the skin or tugging on the skin. My nose has gone a little bit red. Naturally, I have rosacea, so any kind of like touching of the skin kind of makes me flare up, like go red a little bit. But fine, I don't feel dry at all. At all. There's not even like a suggestion of any kind of dryness. Nice. I mean, I wasn't necessarily very oily, but if I was to use a clay mask, this is the kind of clay mask I would use, actually. I actually don't think I'm going to get a whole lot of use out of this because I don't use clay masks that often, because I feel like my natural sebum is controlled because of a lot of other products I use and the way I do my skincare. But if you want to go for a clay mask, I feel like this is the new breed of clay mask where there's no need for it to dry you out. It's got a bit more to it than just being bentonite or kaolin clay in a mixture. Yeah, it's fine. Would I spend my own money on it? Not really, no. Oh, did I mention this was gifted? They sent it to me. Not necessarily personally for my routine, but as I said, if you want a clay mask, I would say this is a nice one to go for. Or one of these two, really, take your pick. Okay, oddly enough, the next one I've really been looking forward to, despite saying I probably wasn't gonna buy it. I said on Instagram over and over, I'm not gonna buy this, because people kept messaging me, tagging me, saying, try this, try this, try this. I was like, no, 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 no. But I caved. This is the Pat McGrath Labs Divine Skin Rose 001, the Essence. This was like nearly 80 quid. This was super expensive. It feels luxury in every way. And honestly, it reminds me a lot of the Dr. Circle kombucha tea essence. You have like your kind of like milky top and then like the more hydrating bottom. Okay, so they say Divine Skin Rose 001, the Essence, a transformative secret to hydrated, revitalized and luminous skin. Oh, Naomi Campbell. I'm always asked, how do I keep my skin looking so healthy and refreshed? I don't go a day without Divine Skin Rose. I'm obsessed with the results, the glow, the luminosity and hydrated. Well, that's not true, because this hasn't been around for that long. Come on now. Sublime to divine in 4 weeks. The essence is formulated with 97% botanically derived ingredients that transform skin in an instant and deliver even more major results over time. Got a lot free from in here. Silicone, parabens, sulfates, gluten, mineral oil, petroleum phthalates. Doesn't really bother me. That's not impressive to me in any way. So obviously one of the key ingredients is rose. They call it rose biotic in here, which calms, rebalances and fortifies the skin barrier, as well as hydrosphere 18. I don't know what any of these are. Nourishes, softens and deeply hydrates. So they say that the pink liquid is the calming rose biotic water and the white liquid is a softening milky hydrosphere emulsion. Right, where are the ingredients? Okay, so in here we have sweet almond oil, glycerin, a few other oils, ceramides, which is quite nice. We do have fragrance, hexylcinnamol, which is one of the more irritating fragrances, which my skin is actually okay with. We have allantoin, which is nice and soothing. Panthenol, nicely moisturizing. Ethyl hexylglycerin, which is nicely hydrating as well. Squalane, nicely moisturizing without being oily and greasy. Okay, right, let's see. I thought we were going to get like your usual hyaluronic acid and all that kind of stuff, but no. Okay, so let's give it a gentle mix. Again, very Dr. Circle. Oh, that is nice. That is very nice. Oh, look at that. Oh my God, this might be like a background piece. Yes, very Dr. Circle green tea kombucha essence. Oh, now here's my issue. Here's why I didn't want to get it. Expensive. Again, it reminded me of a lot more affordable essences. I don't like the smell of rose. So if it smells like rose, I'm going to be really sad because I hate it. Oh, very milky. Doesn't smell like rose at all. Okay, good. Oh, it does a little bit. I wouldn't say it's rose though. It's, I don't know what that is. It's like, I don't know what that is, but it's not rose. It doesn't smell like rose. Well, obviously it is because it's got rose in it, but it's not horrible dusty rose. I call it where it smells like potpourri or whatever it's called. Potpourri. I don't know. It's nice though. I like this. I like this a lot. It's got a slightly more moisturizing feeling than a lot of essences I use. I will keep comparing it to the Dr. Ciracle one because that one is somehow very, very hydrating and a little bit moisturizing, whereas this, you can feel that moisture on your skin. It's probably those oils, the squalane, that are kind of giving me this more kind of like dewy, oily kind of finish to my skin. I'm not sure for someone with an oily T-zone if this is like a summer essential. Do you know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't be slapping this on during the day. In the evenings though, it's very, very nice. Maybe it's a bit too surface level glowy. Like, I can feel this. It's quite tacky to the touch. I know it's Pat McGrath, so it's probably the ideas that you probably use it in conjunction with makeup. I don't hate it. Here's the thing though, looking at the ingredients, I don't really think these are worth my money personally. I prefer something like the Dr. Ciracle Green Tea Kombucha Essence because the ingredients in that are a lot more kind of what I need for my skin. Soothing, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, all that kind of stuff. Whereas this just feels like it's made to nicely hydrate and make you glow, which is absolutely fine. But obviously the Dr. Ciracle one is a lot more affordable. If you have the money to spend on this, do it. If you don't, I wouldn't say you're missing out on anything. You can get this glow from a lot of other products. And it does just feel a little bit oily on the skin. So this is definitely just an evening product for me. I'm going to keep using it, I must be honest. Well, I'm going to keep using it because it was 80 fucking quid and I need to use it. Otherwise, it was a waste of money. But I don't hate it. I don't hate it. When it comes to skincare, obviously first impressions aren't a great kind of like foreshadowing of what's to come with the product. You need a good amount of time to test it. But as far as hydrating results go, it's pretty instant. So I do enjoy this for that so far, but I'll have to give you an update maybe in a month's time. But it does make me feel fancy, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, let's move on to the next one. It's been about 4 or 5 days since I filmed this video and I'm still using the Pat McGrath Labs Divine Skin Rose 100 whatever it is essence. I love it. I really, really like it. It's so moisturizing and hydrating at the same time. And just gives you this glow that whilst the weather's warm, as someone with oily T-zone, I can't really wear during the day. But in the evening, to help me go to bed and kind of wake up with still dewy, plump, non-dehydrated feeling skin, it's a really nice product. Again, very comparable to the Dr. Ciracle Kombucha Essence. I don't think I'll be rebuying the Pat McGrath Labs Divine Skin Essence, but if you like it, you have the money for it, and it's the only essence you're going to use and you want to keep rebuying it, I don't see why you wouldn't want to. Do you know what I mean? But I stick by saying if you don't have the funds for this one, you're not really missing out on anything. It's just more it's just more moisturizing, I would say, than a lot of essences I've ever used, but I am thoroughly enjoying it. My skin is too. Okay, the next one is more kind of like a skincare makeup hybrid, but this is the Key Soul Care Let Me Glow Illuminating Serum. All over TikTok. I love Key Soul Care skincare. It's so good. So good. Like, look at the packaging. That is so nice. So nice. And this is basically that skincare. Oh, should I? No, I'm not going to moisturize because I feel like the essence was kind of enough to keep me moisturized, to be honest with you. Having a bit of an oily day as well. So this is a skincare makeup hybrid, in my own words. Excuse me as I Google it. That TikTok convinced me to buy because it is everywhere. A hydrating, illuminating complexion and makeup priming serum that reveals a healthy golden glow while helping brighten, plumpen, and smooth the look of your skin. For skin type, normal, dry, combo, oily, so everyone really. This says it's a warming glow for all skin tones, which I've seen proof of on TikTok, brightens complexion over time, hydrates, plumps, and revitalizes, improves the look and wear of makeup. We have niacinamide in here, so obviously to help brighten and even out your skin tone. Rose water, again, antioxidant rich hydrator, helps replenish dry, dull skin. And they say that the Soul Care benefit helps you radiate with confidence and lets your inner light shine through. That's cute. There is mica in here, so I do feel like this is one of those products that, according to their description, gives you that temporary glow with the mica, which I'm guessing is ethically sourced, being called a soul's key Soulcare, whilst niacinamide basically and antioxidants help improve your complexion over time. So really, it's an antioxidant serum with mica in it, which I'm not angry about, and some color as well. So let's see, I'm gonna start off just with a couple pumps. Maybe that's too much. I'm gonna do this and then do this. This is very rosy. It's like a plastic rose. That's too much. That was too much. That's too much. It's too much. I can still feel that essence kind of like on my skin. It's definitely left. It's definitely an evening time thing. But look, this is like too much. No. Do you know what? I could see if I didn't use that essence that this is gonna like be really nice on the skin. It doesn't actually feel any like stickier or greasier or anything than it did before after the essence. That's calmed down a bit. I don't think it's really, I don't know. I think it's okay. I can't really tell a difference other than when I first applied it. You know what? I'm going to try it without the essence and I'll insert it here. I'll try it tomorrow morning and let you know how it looks. But at the moment, I do like how my skin looks, but I don't really know what to put that down to, whether it's the essence or the mix of that. It's definitely got a glow to it. It's definitely got a dewy glow to it. Yeah, I think so. But what I think the most impressive thing is how makeup goes over the top of this, which obviously we won't be doing here, but I've seen on TikTok, a lot of people are very happy with it. So I'll try it tomorrow. I'll insert it here. I'll have to film on my phone because I'll be in a hotel. But if you're a fan of no makeup makeup looks, this could be nice to use as an everyday serum to gradually improve your skin tone over time. Hello. So, I didn't do an update because I ended up not trying this product again. The Illuminating Serum, the mica in it was too micery to the point where, I know there's a difference between mica and glitter, but it did look like I had gold bits of glitter on my face. The mica was very obvious, and that's personally not what I look for in illuminating products. I get that it's probably best to use under makeup, and that's probably the real intention of this product, but they do say you can wear it just for, as an illuminating serum, and for me the illumination was a bit too artificial and only really relied on the mica. That's why I prefer products like Glow Recipes, Niacinamide Dew Drops, that give you that kind of glow from within because it hasn't just got mica in it. They did actually end up sending me, literally after I finished filming, they sent me the PR packet. Spins like this, look, and it's in there. I bought my own. So yes, I didn't end up trying it again. I actually washed my face because it was too much. So it's not a product that I'm gonna keep trying. On camera, it looks very nice. Under makeup, I'm sure it looks very nice. So the last thing I want to use, no one asked me to review this, but I'm interested in this. This is Hello Sunday. Full disclosure, I've had a sponsored job with them recently, but this isn't part of the sponsored job and I will have one going forward. But this is one of my favorite sunscreen brands. It's as close to K-beauty sunscreen as you're gonna get here in the UK. So much easier for everyone to get, but this is called the one for your eyes, and this is an SPF 50 mineral eye cream, brightening and lifting, UVA UVB protection. I just want to know, is this gonna sting? Is it gonna be, it's mineral, so is it gonna be overly white cast? There's mica all over my hands. It's a little bit tinted, so let's see, because usually I just kind of like put my sunscreen, put my sunscreen over my eyes normally and hope for the best. So a sunscreen that's specifically made for around the eyes interests me. There's no reason why you can't bring that down a bit. Definitely made my eyes look a lot more awake, right? That looks good. That looks really good. Oh, thank God. No, I really like the look of that. Oh, I like that a lot. Compared to my red nose though, look at that. No, I like that. Because it's mineral, it's giving me like a little bit of a white cast underneath. Hang on. No, it's not left me a white cast, but it does look like it's like brightened under my eyes. Has it, or is it just my imagination? I can't tell. I like that though. No stinging yet. I'll keep you updated, but there's no stinging in there whatsoever. Oh, I really like that. Mineral sunscreen shouldn't sting your eyes, but as a non-mineral sunscreen user, it's nice to have something separate I can use for under my eyes. So those are the products you convinced me to try, TikTok and myself, that I said I wasn't going to try. But let me know what you think about some of these products. As I mentioned, first impressions aren't really like that useful when it comes to skincare. So I will keep you updated on these, but I think it's nice to know how the textures and stuff work on certain skin types and what you think is initial first impression as far as hydration. Temporary glows, reducing the appearance of oils and pores, all that kind of stuff. So let me know what you think in the comments down below, what ones you want an update on of these. I'm liking how my skin looks, I must say. It looks a good amount of dewy. But let me know what you think. We can watch some more skincare reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.